Hello guys, Middle of Fan 147 here with my first PS3 Let's Play, finally. For those of you who don't know, I did get a PS3 for my birthday last year, but it turns out the person who sold it to my mum, who got me for my birthday on eBay, it turns out he sold a banned PS3. I mean, he must have just got banned out of his account and then just sort of started fob off to someone else, but I want to sign into my PSN and download shit and earn trophies and all that. So, just recently again, by April, but 6 months later, I can't believe it's been 6 months already since I got my PS3, where's the time going? But yeah, finally got myself a new one off the C Exchange website. They do them very cheap on there. I got them for £55 and it was legit. So I'm very happy about that. Just wished my mum could have been refunded for the one she previously got me, because I don't like how she got conned on that. But I just finally got signed into the PSN last night, and one of the first games I was really wanting to play on it was, well, I think you all know how much I loved Heavy Rain last year, and I played that around about June. I got recommended this game from my friend Mr. Joseph, who, if you're watching, hello. Yeah, he's also got a Let's Play channel called Mr. Joseph Plays, and another one, Mr. Joseph Reviews channel? Oh, what's the name of your review channel? I'm trying to remember, actually. This was actually the first game I actually ever played by Quantic Dream, thanks to him. Like, he recommended the game to me, because when the game came out on PS4 as remastered, I never heard of the game prior to that, and I'm really glad they remastered it for PS4, because that sort of got me noticing it. But then I played Beyond Two Souls, which I wasn't as keen on in comparison to Heavy Rain, and I played Fahrenheit, and I did like Fahrenheit. But I think overall, my favourite one out of them all was Heavy Rain. I just found the story a lot more interesting, and I really enjoyed it. I just preferred Heavy Rain to Fahrenheit, but I did like Fahrenheit. And I'm not going to lie, guys, ever since that vlog I did years ago, I still have nightmares about that mad doctor. But what we're going to play today is a DLC that didn't come out along with the PS4 release of this game. It was only released on the PS3, and it's actually an incomplete version of the Heavy Rain DLC, because they were originally going to release it as part of a series, I think it was. Like, you were going to have Heavy Rain Chronicle 1, the Taxidermist, which is off Madison, but they were going to release another one about how Jaden became addicted to tryptocaine, and I don't know who else's they were going to do. Probably going to do one of each of them, but this was going to be Madison's one. But I think it was rushed or something like that. They couldn't complete it due to them trying to promote PlayStation Move, which is another just another way of boosting their new products. They don't really care about creativity and people putting effort into their stuff, like saying, like, no, don't put effort into your games. We're just going to promote our consoles, darling. They just released the one Chronicle as a DLC, and you can just play it. It's a prequel. So yeah, we'll just play it now. I've played it already, but I've not played it already. You know what I mean? I've seen Let's Plays of it. I've seen Mess Yourself play it, and I've seen PewDiePie play it. And yeah, this is what the main menu of Taxidermist looks like. It's the only one we can play. And Madison has a different voice actress in this. Like, I was supposed to try to say there. She's voiced by the same person who plays Carla in Fahrenheit, but then they replaced it with someone else when the actual game of Heavy Rain came out. So I think this was actually made before Heavy Rain was, and they originally had her voice actress back for just doing this, but then they obviously had to replace her after that. I'm not really sure why, but I'm not sure if I mentioned this a minute ago already, but believe it or not, I still have nightmares about that mad doctor. And I know I said, like, in my previous vlog, like, oh, I had a nightmare about him once, but I keep having nightmares about him all the time. I don't know why. But that scene seems to have really stuck with me. I don't know why, but that scene in the doctor's house, you know, that guy who was renting those apartments on Marble Street? I don't know, I guess that part just struck me. But then, this DLC isn't any better. So, by any better, I mean, like, isn't any less traumatizing for Madison. I mean, no wonder she's got insomnia. Like, some people are saying, like, I wonder how she got insomnia. I'm like, probably because of all the shit she's had to face. She's probably, like, faced so many fears. Yeah, I just started this off the other day, but I didn't do anything, really. Outside Leyland White's house. Leland Black's house.
Madison Page.
Okay. Madison, it's Sam. I got the information you asked for.
Okay. You've got the information asked for, Sam, but yeah, let's turn on subtitles. Yeah. Madison Page. So yeah, Sam's got the same voice, but she hasn't. You know what it's like? The owner of the apartment on Marble Street is Dr. Adrian Baker. Okay. Menu English, audio English, validate. There we go. That'll do. Just need subtitles. Cool.
The guy's name is Leland White. He used to be a taxidermist, 40 years old, single, apparently out of work for the last 2 years. No criminal record, no psychiatric history.
A taxidermist? That's pretty original. You got his address? I'd like to ask him a few questions.
His last known address was 411 Harbor Street, Lexington.
I'd like to ask him a few questions.
Think this guy could be the origami?
So, Mr. Taxidermist, how's it fleeing?
The only way to find out is to go and ask him. If it's not him, he'll give me some tips on how to stuff animals.
And he's the killer.
And we've got the scoop of the year.
Shit, you're really nuts.
That's why you like me.
Be careful, Madison. You never know.
Don't worry. I'll be fine.
I'm not sure it's just the fact I was too used to Madison's other voice, but it's just weird to hear another different voice. And yeah, I was just remembering when testing this the other day that you have to hold down R2 to move your characters in this. So apparently she reported like the Afghanistan war or something like that.
4:15 p.m. I'm at the home of the suspect Leland White.
I could be a bit wrong about that, okay. At the home of the suspect of Leland White with my dictaphone. And God, it's amazing how many psychos there are in this town that they live. Like, a lot of shit needs to get taken care of. It's funny how we're investigating like the origami killer, yet there's a lot more going on. I think even at this point in time, she's still investigating the origami killer. Oh yeah, she is. That's why she's investigating the taxidermist right now. But no, he's just yet another psycho.
Woman's shoe, dark stains. Looks like blood.
Oh. Not seen anyone looking there yet.
Imagination. Madison Page discovers a serial killer while rooting through a garbage can.
Oh my God! There's kids just playing in the next garden to a serial killer. Look at this. Oh, you can't go talk to them. Okay. But the taxidermist, he's voiced by the same person who plays Scott Shelby, I believe. So, not I believe. He just is. So I know. Oh God! To think when we're running away from the taxidermist, like running here. Surely those kids in the garden next to us would hear him go like, I'm the big bad wolf, sweetie. Okay. Right. Let's go slay some animals. Okay, let's see if he's in. Which he isn't, but let's see if he's in anyway. For the lulz. Madison Page.
Let me in, darling.
She's such a badass. She manages to get out of so many scrapes and situations that people would die in real life. And actually, no, she would have died in the doctor's basement in Heavy Rain if it wasn't for the door ringing conveniently.
Mr. White!
Anybody home? Mr. White?
Mr. Black. Okay, now let's go around the back. That rhymed. Wait, does that say his name on the thingy? It doesn't. It says, USA Mail. USA Mail. You is the mail. Okay. Let's go around the back. I am a bit scared of playing this because I've only ever seen Let's Plays of it, but it looks hard because you have to hide from him and everything, and I know that I'm going to suck at this game to the extent where I have to do the option that's probably like the easiest or the most complicated because I can't avoid any danger.
Looks too high for me to be able to get in that way.
Yes, well, conveniently there's barrels around to help you up. Okay. So, if the person's not in and the door's locked, this is what you should do, guys. Just break in. Just find another way in, yeah. I did, like, why on earth do people bother having locks in their houses if people are just going to find other ways in? Okay. Come on. Okay. So, how do we get in now? All she did was prop that up. Right, okay. Madison, stop it. Shift your butt. Okay. Right, that's not going to work. Okay.
Not much point in trying to get in there. Guess the door's locked anyway.
I wonder why it's not letting me in the window. That's the way I'm supposed to get in, isn't it? Well, the game must be just glitching out on me or something. Right, let me just see if there's another. Ah, there we go, a bigger barrel. There you go.
Kick it over.
Felt that rage. I'm like, I'm so nervous. I'm going to meet a fellow flare in a minute. Oh. So she's got a vent outrage. And yeah, I know this Let's Play is not blind, but I was still all hyped up from having completed Heavy Rain at the time, so I wanted to see more footage. And when I heard it was a DLC, I was like, oh, awesome. So then I watched that. So I didn't assume I was going to be getting a PS3 at that point.
Right.
So.
I really am crazy.
I really, yeah. So this is before she even meets Ethan, so gosh, to think she's having insomnia and all these problems before she meets Ethan in the motel, and she's so freaking chill considering all the near misses she's had. Like, with a freaking hugely built taxidermist, like, with a knife, and a house full of other ladies that obviously never escaped his clutches and he managed to lure in. They could have all been journalists too, coming along to investigate, and he flayed them. Don't know why all these other women would have been to his door. Did he kidnap them or something?
Charming. I'll just have a quick look, take a few photos, and
get out of here fast. Just trying to think about how all those other women actually got to his house. Right, so let's have a look around. But, ugh. I'm a taxidermist, therefore no cleaning for me. Like, his house he's making a point of keeping it untidy. Like, the mad doctor was batshit crazy, but his house was immaculate, darling. Well, apart from his basement. So. This guy, actually, I don't know. It's like both him and the doctor are scary as each other, but this is more disturbing when you see the stuffed woman upstairs. And you also see a dead woman in the bathtub. Yeah, let's just leave his water running. He doesn't deserve to have any remaining water left when he gets home, so...
Women's jewels?
Yeah. He's got a catalogue for ordering women's clothes, too.
Bracelets? Strange place to keep them.
But for all you know, he could just be a cross-dresser, darling. I mean, equality, Madison. Jeez. Wait. Ew.
Gee, think I'm gonna find a story in the fridge?
He's an alcoholic taxidermist. Therefore, he kills women. Right. So it's not in there. Oh. I was going to say, did she say something about weird nostalgia for the past in here? But no, that's the doctor she's on by. Oh. Maybe it's still a weird nostalgia for the past. Is he a taxidermist still? Or is he fired? Just like Adrian Baker was. Like, he's a signed off surgeon. Which I don't blame him. If he's going to drill all those surgeons' vaginas, then I wouldn't blame them. But that matters there. Draw all his surgeon's vaginas? I meant to say draw all his patient's vaginas. So let's have a wee sit down on his manky couch. They probably farts on all the time and burps and flays people on. I get strange vibes from this couch. Okay, I'm getting off now. Should we check his card? Oh, what about his fireplace? Burnt fabric? Probably from a fight he got in. With another suspect,
not burnt clothes
victim.
In the fireplace. Look like women's clothes.
Maybe, yeah, another woman who isn't as rad and badass as Madison didn't manage to get out of a scrape with him and then got killed and flayed and then got stuffed. But surely you'd have to get a perfectly shaped model to cover the skin over, because I thought when it came to stuffing, you have to have, like, a mold or something. Like, how could you stuff people? Is that possible? I don't know. I don't know how taxidermy works. I remember it's so weird because I actually only just found out what taxidermy was. Like, I obviously knew stuffing animals was a thing, but I didn't know it was called taxidermy until shortly before I heard about this game, conveniently. Because one of my friends at college, well, someone who I knew at college, it says he was into taxidermy, and then shortly after that I heard of this game, and then I was like, ooh. So that was convenient. Well, not convenient, just coincidental. Ugh. Disgusting. I don't think we need to be in here right now. I think we only come here as a means of escape. Well, blood, that could be a sign of something. God, it's a wonder that the parents next door don't decide to move if they have children. I mean, God, surely they hear noises over here, like screaming women. How can this town be so fucked up? Like, mad doctor, mad Jack, taxidermist. There's a bunch of psychos in this town. But no, the origami color is the only one that matters. Now, I know that this... A chronicle has multiple endings, and ooh. Do you see that dog? Oh, we can't investigate him, okay. I think you can climb out that window if we're careful enough, but I probably won't be, will I?
The floorboards creak when I walk on them. It fits this creepy place.
Bit weird that you mention that now, because no one's here to hear you squeak the floorboards. Oh my god! Demonic ball! Okay. Right. So let's just explore shit, and then when he gets home, we'll call the Feather. Now we're gonna go round the badass route, and we're gonna fight that bitch. Oh, I wanna drill his crotch with the chainsaw. I wanna get that ending. How do you do it? Oh my god. Oh, that's the molds. There. Yeah, he's obviously gonna put stuff on that. Like, put on the horns. I wonder how those mold things are made. Like, they make them with clay or something. How does he perfectly shape the woman for wrapping their hide around them? I want your hide, darling. Okay. So dark, I can't see it. Let's leave y'all. Whoops, no, get in y'all. It's so weird that this was only released on PS3. Like, they didn't bother remastering this. Huh? Oh, you can see down the stairs from here. Okay, cool. Now, I was actually wanting to replay Heavy Rain again soon for PS3 and re-earn all its trophies and that, and I was going to maybe do it for the channel because I actually really enjoyed the game so much. And I think I'm going to have my friend Alex join me again in it, but yeah, I was telling her we'll try and take the game a bit more seriously. We won't like talk through all the dialogues and everything, which I'm pretty bad for myself. But all right, okay. So she's not bad enough. Badass enough to use those metal hands and barge into a cabinet. And I can't think of what I'm saying. Okay. So he died looking for the light today. So he was looking up all like. He was probably looking up at Leland's fast. Okay, oh, shit, stop it. Let's look in here. I'm trying to go, okay, that's what I was trying to go. God, this, Heavy Rain's so hard to control. Like, if the camera angle changes while you're still holding down R2, the controllers get confused about where they are.
Things. Dozens of dresses and suits.
Like I said, are you sure that it was Leland and not Leslie or something? I don't know. Let's hide. Oh. Can we go in this room? No, obviously not, because she's refusing to go in. Okay. Is this the bathroom? No, or is this the boudoir? I don't know. Yeah, this is the boudoir full of the dead bodies. Oh, darling. Hello, sweetie. I'm just chilling. Don't mean to inject you with my needle? Oh, okay. Don't mean to take your temperature? I'll suck the poison out. Okay. Oh, cheers, babes. Hey, do you like my tattoo? Oh. This is fucking creepy. They don't look like they've been stuffed yet. They still look a bit too pale. God, she really does put herself in danger for search for the truth. Is Brittany Sanders? Certainly, I can't remember. But Brittany with ICN at the end of Heavy Rain. She was all like, "All this okay claptrap makes me hungry." She was a bitch, but saying that she got lost in the fight for justice. If she dies in Heavy Rain. It's weird, one of the endings in this is she can actually die, which doesn't make sense because it's a prequel and she's alive in Heavy Rain. So I got the photos I need. Is it just a matter of time before he comes home? Do I have to look everywhere? Oh, this is going to be the bathroom. Newly flayed corpse. Oh. Oh, he's got it at her insides, has he? Yeah. But does he just use the skin or does he just remove its insides and then stuff the rest?
In the upstairs bathroom, a body in the bathtub. She was cut up with a saw.
I think when Leland comes in later on, and you're still hidden from him, doesn't know you're here, I think you see him actually continuing to cut her up, and it's disgusting. But I just don't know, like, is there something about this town that everyone just had corrupt childhoods, and they're just naturally fucked up? Oh, bollocks. Okay, put that away. Come on, Madison, you got this, y'all. You're a badass supporter with an amazing bot, so. Oh! Shit. Okay, I wonder if I can sneak out the back. Oh, shit.
Shit.
Okay, now I'm getting nervous. Because it is possible to die here. Which makes no sense with it being a prequel, but. Oh my god, Madison! How come you don't have. Well, of course you have insomnia, but that's the only thing that you got from all this trauma, near-death experiences. I mean, fuck, even what I've seen so far would prevent me sleeping at night, let alone being killed in the mix. Well, someone trying to kill me.
Floorboards creak.
Oh, shit. Shit! Oh!
Floorboards can get me killed.
Oh, I've gone fucked myself already. Oh, hide in here.
Come sniffing round my little secrets.
Oh god, I need to hide. I need to hide! Oh shit. Oh, there's Madison's tense music. Shit.
You've seen my bathtub, haven't you?
Yes, babes. Okay, now can I go hide?
That's where you'll be sleeping
tonight. Oh, fucking hell. I am sucking ass at this so far. No, I'll just wait for him to find me and then... Controls! Stop it! Right, okay. Oh, he found me. Well, let's just flee that bitch, okay. Yeah, I just told you, I'll wait for him to find me and then I'll just dodge all his attacks.
You're gonna be my doll.
Up! There we go.
You're gonna be all mine.
There's no way I can hide here. What the fuck? Oh, you just hide behind this lady. He'll totally never see me. I'm pretty sure he goes boo when he finds me. Hello. She actually looks like she's doing me. Boo. Oh, yeah. Because I'm totally not obviously here. Oh my god, his mouth was so wide open. Oh, I'm getting nervous. Shit. Okay, just dodge all this shit.
Come on, honey. I'm gonna take care of you.
I know, I feel so secure, darling. You're very nice. Okay, oh shit. Oh god. Oh, no. Oh shit. Okay, if I miss one of these QTs, am I gonna die? Okay. Okay, just leave this bitch alone. Run away. That's the same music it plays to that doctor, isn't it? Just remember. Oh, I also defining Sean. Stop running, bitch. Oh, yeah, just let me kill you. I mean, it's not that big a deal. Oh, shit. Ah! Oh, fuck. What did I need to do that for? Let's go check. Wannabe, you'll never be Big B. Okay, let's go. Oh! I remember this music scared me. It used to, anyway, but... When I was fighting the Mad Doctor, I remember this music scared me. Well, it sort of... It coincided with the actual drama of the scene. Oh, shit. Ah! Stop stabbing me! Not very nice to kill me. Can we get out this window? Can we open it? It was open earlier. I mean, if it managed to shut so easily, then surely we can open it. I'm just gonna go with the ending I get, guys. I'm not gonna try to get all endings just now. Oh, fuck. Because all endings are on YouTube anyhow, so. Oh, it won't take very long, so yeah, just let me kill you. I mean, life sucks anyway, so. Oh, shit. It's no good! Okay, alright, wait, we need to flee that bitch. Where's the chainsaw? Okay, open it. Open. So you can actually leave without him even knowing you're here. And then he won't bother chasing you. And this part is so dense when you're actually trying to get your bike to start and he starts walking towards you. That's so fucking creepy. Like, yeah, the kids next door are not going to see us at all. Start! Shit! Sickle goal, come on! My press is fast enough. Come on. Oh, shit. Oh, please, am I doing this quick? Oh, good, I do it. Oh, R2! Yes! Oh, phew. I pressed start 1 for a second. Oh my god, I did it! I didn't get a chance to hide behind anything because the controllers are being a twat, so... Hang on, I'm gonna see if I can hide from him. Okay, yeah, actually, I'm gonna see if I can get another ending. I'm gonna try and... not get caught by him. Actually, I don't know, because I want to see the other endings, because I think you can go back to certain chapters, can you? When you just shot himself. Well, so after all those other girls you flayed, the one that got away is the one that made you kill yourself. What the fuck? Our reporter, Madison Piage, fearless investigation revealed the identity of the dangerous serial killer who stabbed his victims. After killing them, Leland White was found dead. What the fuck? What stupid reason to kill yourself? I'm butthurt because a lady wouldn't let me kill her. Right. Oh, okay, I can skip the credits. Awesome. Right. You've seen one of the possible scenarios of this scene. Okay, so... Reload one of your saves. Leland's back. Okay. Oh, that's cool then. There isn't much left from that point onwards. Oh, for a second I thought the game wasn't loading. Oh, and Madison's face is different in this loading screen. Like, they must have done a retake or something for the Heavy Rain game, because that's not the same loading screen for Madison. I like the music from Heavy Rain. I quite often listen to its tunes. And the Blue Lagoon music is epic.
Oh! Leland White is back. Oh.
Shit.
Oh no. I've put my makeup today. I've got to go to the bathroom. That stinky manky bathroom. If you've got a mirror, that's all that matters. I want to change my lipstick, sweetie. Got to keep up appearances for I am a journalist with benefits. Oh. Oh shit. Dude. I really wish more of these release. I mean, I even got PlayStation Move, so I'd rather find out what how.
Floorboards creak.
Oh shit!
Gotta move quietly.
That seemed to move quietly.
Killed.
Oh, it's not hard me yet. Cloudy, windy, and cold this morning, warming up. Stop it, Madison. I'm not even pressing that direction. Don't get killed, Madison. I'll be very selfish of you.
Oh, we seem to have a visitor.
Oh, bollocks. Oh, hang on. A little weasel. Just get out this window. Sniffing round my little secrets. Can we get out this one? Shake, 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 shake. We can't get that one. Oh god. Oh dear. I didn't even squeak the floorboard, just slag. My little darlings? Oh, don't be so smug about finding me. Pretty, aren't they? I mean, if you're gonna kill me, at least do it in a way that doesn't make me want to smack you. I'm gonna have a new one for my collection. I am going to cut you up and add you to my collection, sweetie. Okay. Now, go away. Alright, so once I see him pass that... No, I want to see him pass so that I know I can get out. If you come in here, I swear I'm going to kick you. Oh. He walked past. Right, so he's in there right now. Oh, God. Leave.
Don't okay. Be shy.
I could leave without me even knowing I'm here. Alright, good, he's still checking all the rooms. Hurry up, Madison! Who cares if he hears you squeaking? The faster you are, you'll get out anyway.
Come on. Show your face.
Why the fuck would I do that, you slag?
I'd like us to have a little fun together.
Oh, I bet you would, darling, because you're so hot. Okay, now let's go. Oh my god, he looks like he'd smell his sausages, I mean. Or something. Well, he probably would because he's cutting up a load of sausage meat. Oh, don't you dare look at the back for me. I want to leave without you being aware of my presence. Boo! Yes, he didn't find me. Awesome. So I left having him all triggered and him not knowing where I am. So this is a different ending. So he wouldn't have killed himself in this ending. Let me see. I want to get that ending where she calls the police in his bedroom. No. Ah, so it says a different ending. In the middle of the horror, our reporter Madison Piage managed to sneak into the house of horror, the house of Gaga, of the serial killer. Who stuffed his victims with frosties after killing them. And they were great! The man was arrested at his house in the morning without putting up any resistance. Oh, so he was arrested without even phoning anyone, okay. Okay, skip this shit. Can I skip the credits? Okay, well. Right, so I've got two endings now. The end of the nightmare in the middle of the horror. The end of an anguish. So where is Madison Page? Sacrificed in the name of the truth. Oh. Well, how do we get those two? Because they look like they're... Oh, I know it. Where is Madison Page? I don't phone the police and get killed. Phone the police, get killed. Phone the police and escape. Okay. Right, I've got this. I've got this in the bag, yo. Ugh, just have to wait for this to load again. Her eyes are gorgeous. Oh my gosh, they actually scanned the veins in her eyes. Wow. Hurry up. We got to do this shit. It's a very short DLC. I mean, it only took me like 20 minutes to just do the whole thing. Yeah, it's just funny how it's a minute ago. I'm only going to go with the ending that I had, but I'm just going to do them all for the loss. This guy's creepy. Very creepy, darling. I'll sneak to his bedroom and fap his porn. No, we'll phone the Pollock.
I gotta move quietly. Floorboards are gonna get me killed.
Right. Okay, I'm moving quietly, aren't I? Okay, that's the bathroom. Let's go to his boudoir and call the. Where's the phone? Where is his phone? Oh, okay, I need to know where that shit is.
Oh.
Oh fuck! Seem to have a visitor. No. Don't come upstairs. Well, if I can't find your phone, I'll just let you kill me, because that'll be one of the endings. Wait! Come and get me, babes! Oh, shit. Oh, fucking hell. It's doing it again, where the camera angles
won't... Have you seen my little darlings?
Yeah, they're fabulous.
Oh. Pretty, aren't they? Something tells me I'm gonna have a new one for my collection.
Aw. You may be disappointed. You know, just maybe. Also. Yeah, there's his bed.
Yeah.
Don't ask any questions. Just send the police to Leland White's house right now.
Matt.
Please.
Give it.
Wait. Where is he right now? I thought he was in his bedroom. Hide under his bed. I mean, he will look under here eventually, but we just have to stay hidden until the police come along. Right, so I call the police. Please, Sam! Just do as I say. Well, sadly, there was no phone to rescue her in the doctor's basement. And even if there was, she was tied up, so she couldn't call anyone. If he looks under my bed, I'll be very pissed. He's nowhere near me right now. The police will come for him soon enough. Oh, hurry up, Sam! You're a shitty co-worker.
I'm gonna cut up your skin and add you to my collection.
That's not very nice. Oh shit! You found me. I knew it was maritime. I know you always find you if you keep on hiding. Oh come on. Bun prompts. Save the day. Oh. Gosh. What are the chances of her dodging this? I mean, he's massive. He'd get her, honestly. I'm panning it. Ugh. Yes. Madison is savage. Fucking love her. Like, she must have trained in martial arts or something before becoming a fabulous journalist. Oh, triangle. Would she fall down the stairs if I didn't press triangle there? Or is it just the illusion of choice? What? Come on, police. I phoned you already. Okay. I can't prize it myself, can I? Oh, yeah. I was stupid. I should have used the hydraulics or whatever it's called. Watch out. Don't let him flee you. Oh fuck. Can we drill his bollocks? Where's the chainsaw? Oh, what did that woman need? Chainsaw his nuts. Oh. Come on. Bust that lock, bitch. Okay. Oh, come on. Locks are too cool for Madison Page. Okay, come on. Locks are not too cool for Madison Page. Oh, fucking hurry up, Sam. What kind of co-worker are you?
I want your hide. You hear me? I want your hide.
Oh, yes, I want your hide so bad too, darling. Oh.
You're gonna be my doll. My pretty little doll.
Oh.
You're gonna be all
what the fuck? Oh, yeah, just hide under this bed. He'll never find me, yeah. Oh, try to press cycle. Okay. Boo! Sam.
Come on, visitor. Show your face.
Sam, I called you like 1 minute ago. You should be here already. Just gonna flee real bad. Boop. Yep, he's gonna go under the bed. Yep. Right, so we just need to focus on getting outside now, because I think that's the only thing
come
for
on,
it.
Honey. I'm gonna take care of you.
Right, does he only ever say come on honey in this room in particular? This is come on honey room, is it? Oh shit. Oh fuck! I just missed one button prompt! Oh well, we got an ending anyhow. Oh shit, I'll be smug fast.
Oh, I'm dead. Woe is me.
Hey babe, that was very sexy the way you stabbed that bitch.
Yes.
I've been missing you all again.
Police! Open immediately!
Oh, yes. So, sacrifice the name of the truth. That's the ending I got here.
Don't move right, shoot! Hands up! Hands up, I said!
Hands up, I said! Fuck's sake, they took their time. Dun, dun. What happened here?
Oh my God, what happened here?
So we've got two more endings to get. That's not the one I was trying to get there, but it was still one of the endings. Sacrifice in the name of the truth. Well, that's her biker jacket that she wears in the actual game, but she has a different one in this prequel. The police have found fearless journalist Madison Page dead in the home of a serial killer. She was about to have sex with him very hard until he flayed her. To reveal the concerning truth. The mysterious disappearance of several women when she herself was savagely flayed. The police have arrested the psychopath responsible for her flaying. Okay. I love the word flayed, don't I? That sounds like a low-pitched version of her action sequence. Right. So, end of an anguish. That will be to phone the police and not get killed. Right. So, I think I remember where his bedroom is. His bedroom, I think it's near, like, when you turn round, when you're at the top of the stairs, it's straight on. Like, you don't turn right. That's where his bedroom is. Okay, I just need to know where that is straight away. Before he adds me to his collection. Okay. So I have to make sure he doesn't hear me. And he doesn't know where I'm hiding, because I think the police actually come sooner that way. Yeah, because the police take longer if the person that you are reporting finds you. That's totally logical, isn't it? It's kind of funny how I still managed to get an ending I never got yet, without even trying. I was trying to get a different one. I can't believe it's actually that easy to get killed in this game, because I know some people are saying, like, it's so easy not to get killed, but I got Norman killed in my blind Let's Play, and I didn't mean to. I remember I had to replay Mad Jack to unkill him. Now, I almost got Madison killed at the dock scene, but conveniently he goes to the door a second time. Oh!
Floorboards creak.
Okay, so you can change the camera off, I got it. No, Madison, go the other way.
The forecast, cloudy, oh, fuck. Windy and cold this morning, warming up a bit.
Right, there's his bedroom. Okay, he's not heard me. I thought the floorboards just creaked. Okay, don't hide, Jay. Doesn't even know you hear you, idiot.
Oh.
Oh, well, you can go fuck yourself. Oh, why does he keep hearing me? No matter how slow I go.
Don't ask any questions. Just send the police to
we seem to have a visitor.
Right now.
He doesn't seem to have a very real face.
Please, Sam.
Did they scan his face?
What I say?
You know, little weasel coming to sniff around in my little secrets.
Without being invited, don't you?
Yas. Yas, queen.
I
right.
Can't stand people who don't respect my privacy.
I can't stand people who don't respect my skin. Okay. Ah! R2, oh, just get under the fucking bed, Madison. It's very hard to hold all these buttons in place. I should have said, no, I suck at this game. I'm not familiar with the controller at all. Oh. Okay, so just make sure I don't die then this time. He is so annoying. He finds you no matter what. He knows literally every nook and cranny of this fucking house. Oh, L1. Okay. Don't mistaken. The R's and L's. I remember I had to press, like, I think it was R1 earlier that got me killed, and I pressed R2, or the other way around, I can't remember. Right, so remember to go for the hydraulics this time. Let me kill you, it's much easier for me, I don't care about what benefits you, okay. Which one's the back garden? Okay, that one's the back garden, is it? Yeah. The front door won't unlock. Okay. Big bad wolf. Okay. Left. There we go. Open that bitch. Okay. Up. Oh, yeah, I forgot you have to do this slowly, yeah. When it says to press up, you have to sort of do it slowly for it to work at times. But if you do it too quick, it quite often just shows up as red. I don't know what's that. Right. Okay, I'm starting that shit. Wait, I phoned the police. Wait, I left, but the police were still phoned. Oh, he's annoying. Are the police not still coming for him? Boom. Oh, well, the police just decided not to come, so Sam wanted me to die. Okay. Bitch. Alright, okay, we're gonna try again for this ending, because it can't be that hard. Come on. He has to not know where I am. But it would help if you stop going, oh, we seem to have a visitor, sweetie. Okay. It's going to show her face in it again. Yeah. Oh, long loading screen. So I think this came out in like 2009, and I never even knew about it.
Shit.
I'm technically playing on its original release, because I'm not playing the remaster right now. I'm playing on the PS3. It's funny how she was running there, but she's all like, oh, well, once he's inside, I have to go really slow because the floorboards creak, so. I swear, if the floorboards creak this time, I'll be so pissed.
Floorboards creak? I've got to move quietly. These floorboards are going to get me killed.
Madison, turn around, you twat. Okay.
The forecast, cloudy, windy, and cold this morning, warming up a bit.
Okay. How the fuck do I move slowly?
Oh,
go fuck yourself, slag.
A little weasel comes sniffing round my little secrets.
Phone, okay.
Yeah.
Don't ask any questions.
I'll hide this boudoir. That'll take him longer, won't it?
Okay. Right now.
Matt,
oh shit, hang up. Sam, you worthless piece of shit. Just fuck off. No, hang on.
Pretty, aren't they?
Yeah, they're pretty, okay. Oh, just let me go.
I'm gonna have a new one for my collection.
That's nice, okay. I couldn't be more happy for you, mate, but... Oh! Oh! No! Darling! Oh! Oh, wait. I phoned the police, so let him kill me, because that'll be one ending. Stab me! Stab the shit out of me, babe. Come on.
Baby doll.
Little doll. You're gonna be all mine.
Stab me. Come on.
Come on, honey! I'm gonna take care of
you. Oh wait, no. Oh wait, no. Oh, I shouldn't have phoned Sam. What the fuck? Okay. These endings are pretty hard to get, bitch. Oh, just get this flaying over with, darling. Okay. Oh, okay. Back to main menu. Right. I'll just select the chapter I want to do.
It's hilarious that you died.
So. Oh, I don't know, he pisses me off. But I know what I could have done there if the freaking camera just responded. Right, Leland is back! Okay, let's go. Okay, I'll just run down the stairs and let him stab me and I won't call the police. Because I'll be, where is Madison Page? We're not going to bother checking the taxidermist's house where she said she was going. Oh, they'd find us just because I never phoned Sam. Like, he's saying, well, I've not seen her in a while, but she never phoned me. Therefore, everything must be okay because when people die, they could totally phone me to let me know. Silly Sam. Right, now stab me properly this time. Stop stabbing me at the wrong moments. If you're gonna kill me, do it right.
Oh.
Right. Whoa, Leland, sup, honey?
Oh.
Woohoo! Come and stab me! Yeah, oh, I need a good filling. Oh, yes. Hey, sweetie. Come down to the Blue Lagoon for a lap dance. Oh, yes. Oh no! Oh my god, how on earth did you heal me? I haven't phoned the police or anyone. Okay. Stab me, bitch. Alright, let's go.
You're gonna be my doll.
My baby doll. Don't press anything, just let him stab me.
All mine.
All mine? What's the point in running anywhere? I don't have to anyway. Stab me. I wanna die. I'm super suicidal. Okay.
Oh, yes. I like it rough, darling.
Oh, yes. Oh, hilarious. Bitch. Oh, you enjoyed that, did you? It's very fun to watch you stab people, darling, yes. I liked it too, and I'm a nurse, by the way. Look at you, lying there being all dead and shit. Stupid bitch. So, we're getting the... Where is Madison Page ending? Yes, there we go. We've had no news for several days now. Why do you go fucking check the taxidermist then? Like, the police are questioning a taxidermist. She is thought to have wanted to question... No shit! What the hell? No doubt the taxidermist will be like, I don't know what the fuck you're talking about. I mean, it's not as if... Like, he's going to say, I don't know what the fuck you're talking about, and we're going to be like, oh, okay, sorry, Leland, okay, we'll let you go about your business. We're not going to bother investigating your house to see if there's any, you know, dead bodies around here that look a bit like Madison Page. Right, so we'll phone the police, and if he hears us, fuck life, no, if he hears us, we'll run down the corridor, and we'll hide in his boudoir, because he'll take longer to search down there, and surely the police will come before then, so, unless it's the police up in, up here. then they're like, oh, what the fuck even is a crime? Right. So we just got one more ending to get. Two endings mean she's dead. And the other three just pretty much her alive, but with slight different outcomes. I suppose that does matter. Because usually in these sort of games, like, the only choices is who dies and who lives, but there's other choices in, like, how an outcome comes about of them living or whatever.
Shit.
God, it's almost taken me 50 minutes to play this, and this is not even a long DLC. What the fuck's wrong with me? Oh, I enjoyed playing this. I was actually looking forward to playing this for ages when I saw the DLC. I'm like, damn it, bitch, I don't have a PS3 now. I need to get one to play this, but that's not the whole reason I got it. I just decided after a while, okay, there's lots of games I'm actually want to get for PS3 now. They're exclusive to the PS3, so it's like, okay, I'm going to get PS3. So I thought, while I'm at it, I'll read by Heavy Rain. Oh. We seem to have a visitor. Oh, I'll just run. There we go. Call him already. We seem to have a visitor. Yes, be quick about it. Okay, let's go.
Don't ask any questions. Just send the police.
Little weasel. Oh, he's to say, oh, that's nice of him to not talk through me.
Because
if I wasn't on the phone right now, he'd say, a little weasel sniffing around my little secrets.
Show your face.
Right, Madison, please.
I'd like us to
Madison, please. Control properly. Okay. Now run. Before he sees you. Okay. Run to his boudoir. Make his body say, ah. Oh.
You're not supposed to barge in on people without being invited,
fuck the police. I'm above the law. All right.
I can't stand people who don't respect my privacy.
Are you serious, bro? This is seriously the first place you're going to check? Oh, God. If you check under your bed, I'll be so annoyed. You found me. Damn it. Oh, the floorboards always seem to creak no matter how slow I'm trying to go. Okay, just hide in the freaking closet, okay? It'd be like what I was until I was 17. Okay, a moment to live in my shoes, Madison. Or I'll just stay in the closet until it's time to come out, which will probably never. So just hide here. Because the first place he goes is right to the boudoir. Okay, so hopefully the police will stop being dumbasses and come along. Okay, I didn't let go, but never mind. Get back in, you div.
I like playing too.
I hate playing, it's lame. Why were you quicker this time at checking your boudoir? If you check your wardrobe, I'll be so pissed. I can't fucking get this ending where he doesn't even know I'm there and I phone the police. There's a room we can hide behind a rack or something. Oh fuck you!
Sniffing around my little
We'll let him pass us and then run down the stairs. Yes. Why didn't I think of that before? Like, when the dumbass goes to his boudoir, we'll just run down the stairs, okay? Right, he's going in there, run. Make a run for it. Run for us, run.
I'll soon teach you to keep your nose out of other people's business.
Fight me. Can we hide in the fridge? We'll hide in the parking lot? Can we hide under stairs? Oh yeah, sneak down the steps.
No, you're not supposed to barge in on people without being invited, don't you?
No, but thanks for the inside info. Hurry up, Sam. Just do something useful for once in your life. Look, can you not just admit it might have been the wind and then go like, oh, maybe I didn't hear anyone. Why are you so adamant there's someone here?
Am I hot?
No, you're definitely not hot. Oh, come on, where's the police at? I phoned you ages ago, Sam. Your services are required. Oh, he keeps checking his downstairs. Oh! He's given up. I can't exactly do anything right now. If I go inside the house, he'll see me, so... Am I hot or am I warm? Right. It's your way of saying, I'm not cold. Either way, I've got your hide. Okay, don't get out of that room anytime soon. Come on, let's go. Because I got to get into the corridor. Oh, shit. He's back in the corridor. Oh, no, he's not now. Leave quickly, bitch. Oh, shit. Oh, go ahead in the bathroom. Have a quick... Shit.
Don't be shy.
Madison, what the fuck are you playing at? Oh! Oh my god, go fuck yourself. Oh, he's got a knife like Negan's. No one's gonna hurt you. Well, he's in there, let's run and we'll hide in the closet under the stairs. I'm pretty sure that's what we can do. Madison, no, now's not time for back controls. Fucking move it!
So you wanna play hide and seek?
No, I just wanna go home. I hate playing. Oh, now that I'm not hiding in the closet anymore, you check the other room first.
Show your face.
No, I don't want to get killed.
I'd like us to have a little fun together.
No offense, but you don't strike me as the fun type. You're a bit boring, darling. Oh, come on, please. How long does it take you to drive in a house? I mean, how big can this town possibly be? It's not as if there's another mad doctor out there. Oh, I swear to fucking God. Right, well, he seems to be exploring the boudoir while I'm in his bedroom right now, so hang on. Yeah, I'll have to get back under the bed. Or hide in the closet. Yeah, because he's taking so long to explore there. Hopefully the police will be here by the time he's come back to this bedroom. Yeah, he thinks I'm in there right now. He's going to look under the bed now, isn't he? Now, please don't make the next room you check be this one, because that's so unfair. Because I've noticed every time I'm hiding in a certain room, that's always the next room he checks. And, oh, yeah, that's what he's doing. That's exactly what he's doing. I'm not hiding just now. I've noticed when you're not hiding somewhere in particular, he doesn't look directly at where you're hiding. So I've got to wait till he's walked down to his boudoir. Oh, and that's what he's checking first. Fuck. No, check your bedroom. Oh, yeah, like I'm going to hide in your bathtub. What the hell? God, when I phoned what's-his-name last time. What? And how did you find me? I'm just going to see if I can stay in the house till the police arrive. I don't know. Keep on dodging him, but not leave. If that makes sense. Oh, try through the window, because I know that doesn't work. Oh, bollocks. Okay, let's go. Don't take them. Damn it, Shelby, you scary. Otherwise, it's nae good. Can we drill his bollocks? Oh, there's the... Oh, actually, I know this is not relevant to what I was trying to do right now, but let's just do this shit for lols. Okay. The end of an anguish, bitch. Okay. Drill his bollocks. He can still get us even if we've got the drill, if we don't do this properly. I think he can still stab me with the drill in my hand. Yes, oh no, I didn't get him. Shit. Oh, bollocks. Oh, God, I can feel that. I know how that would feel. What a way to die. God, he looked like he enjoyed that. I'm like, why the fuck? Yeah, he's switching. Yep. That is fucking painful. Just being kicked in that is sore enough. Right, so we didn't get the ending. The police came along to save the day. But we killed him. I was wanting to see how it go if I used a chainsaw, but I couldn't find the chainsaw before. Watch children. 16. Watch the children. What? The watch children sign is right next to the taxidermist house. It's like saying, it should say watch out for any local taxidermists. I mean, what the fuck? But he keeps fucking going, we seem to have a visitor even when I'm walking slowly. It's so cool how the one DLC that was released was of Madison, because I know, like, Madison was one of my favourite characters anyhow in the game, so. Okay, I'm sneaking. Right, I sneaked all the way to the phone there. Hopefully that worked. I don't think I ran at all. No. If you dare say... Oh, I didn't do anything to indicate I was here. I snuck all the way. Did I touch anything to indicate I was here? Right, he's looked behind there that time. So if he goes into the boudoir right now, I'm going to run into that room and hide behind that rack. Something tells me you're going to be crotchless soon if you're not careful. Right, okay. Is he going in the boudoir? He is. Okay, Madison, run like the wind. Okay. Madison, go fuck yourself. Okay, Mr. Taxidermist Laddie, could you stay inside the boudoir just now, please? That'd be very beneficial to me. Okay, Madison, get your shit together. Okay, so the controls in this are just mental. I swear, what? Where the hell did you come from? You just sort of popped up out of nowhere. Is it because I've been in his fridge or something? I don't know. Should I probably not snooped so much? Should I just gone straight upstairs and find the important shit? Okay, I'm gonna go running straight for the boudoir, then next. I like playing too, darling. Oh, right, so you're nowhere near me right now, but are you just gonna randomly find me, like, at one point? Selfish bitch. Right, so it looks like the little bastard is actually just very observant, and he kept noticing that I tampered with drawers. Yeah, right enough, I did open a shit ton of drawers and not bother to close anything, so it wasn't the fact he heard the floorboards creaking. He must have went over to the fridge and noticed I tampered with stuff, because they say if you knocked over any animals or... Because I was reading up on the wiki, actually, because I was curious to think if did I move anything that you noticed. So yeah, don't move anything. Like, if you tamper with any of the animals, and I think one of the things was if the basketball's out of the cupboard and you don't put it back, that's a problem. Okay, so we'll just get straight to what we have to look for right now. We won't tamper with anything.
The floorboards creak when I walk on them. Fits this creepy place.
Fits this creepy place. I'll probably edit out all my other attempts because that could have been embarrassing. Right, so we'll just look for the important stuff just now. We'll look in the bathtub and we'll see all the creepiness in his boudoir. And then he'll come home, hopefully. Because once you've found what you need to find, that's when the character you're looking for conveniently shows up. So.
She, cut up with a saw.
Cut up a saw. It wasn't a chainsaw. It was just a saw. So he made a point of making that bathroom look disgusting, did he? Well... He'll probably only notice I'm here once he's upstairs because I'm leaving doors open that weren't open before. So once I've noticed all this shit, hopefully he won't hear me if I walk, because I was walking slowly before. I was just thinking he seemed a bit paranoid to hear a slight squeak, and then he's like, oh, there's a visitor here. Lovely suspenders, darling, yes. Hi. I'm a devil woman. I'm a rebel. I'm just out of the shower, darling. Leave me alone.
This time, I got my story.
I know. And no stripping needed to be done. So I just have to wait for Leland Whitty to come home. Madison, what are you doing? Okay. Leland, honey, I'm home. Are you there? Where? Oh, there he is. Because I've tried going downstairs. There we go. So I had to go upstairs, but conveniently doesn't come home when I'm downstairs. He just walks in and goes like, what are you doing here, harlot? And also, what? Imagine if he was home and I just went to the door and knocked. I'd have totally blown my cover because I would have nowhere to hide because I wouldn't have known what to expect before going in and investigating the place. So if I knocked the door, he'd probably just go like, a woman, and stab me straight away and just drag me in. And I wouldn't have been prepared for it. So conveniently, he wasn't home. Right, so hopefully the bitch won't hear me this time. Right, so I am walking, aren't I? I'm definitely walking slower. So call the police, you bitch. I have a feeling he won't look in the cupboard for no reason.
Yeah.
Please, Sam, just do as I say.
Send the police to Leland White's house right now.
Matt, is that you? What's
going on?
Okay.
Just do what I
That's
say.
Who he kept hearing me. Because of the beer, of course. What the fuck? How could he? All I did was open the fridge. How can he tell the fridge was open? God, even I ain't got that little of a life. Okay. There we go. Just hide in here. Because apparently he goes upstairs for a quick power nap and shag. And then... There we go. So just stay hidden. Tell the police to come along. However long that'll be, I'll probably like 3 minutes or something. Because I noticed in the Let's Play, so I'll just there, it took like 3 minutes for the police to arrive. So I just have to... Well, I seriously have to hold this position for 3 minutes? Oh, now we can do this. We got it in the bag, yo. You see, yeah. I'm using both hands to do this. I'll just use one hand in. Oh, he looks so derp. He looks like someone who had bullied me in high school. But like a fat version of him, an older, and that was disgusting. So not only are you a taxidermist, but you burp. That's gross. Oh, just to put the fear into Madison, I'm going to just browse the house, even though I don't know she's here. I didn't tamper with anything, I don't think. What's that I just touched? Oh god, please don't do that. I'm actually needing a wee myself, and that's not helping. Good. He doesn't know where I am, so he's not looking for me. Oh, please hurry up. Didn't wash your hands? Well, that's unhygienic. Okay. Didn't even flush the toilet. Like, flushing's for the hygiene freaks or something. Okay. Oh, please. I think he does go for a lie down. I can't see any reason why he would check his closet without knowing there's anyone here. Oh, he's not even going on the bed. Okay. Okay, my thumb and fingers are getting sore now. Ow. This is really difficult to hold. Oh god, no! Madison, get back in, you harlot! Okay, go. Bitch! Get back in! No! 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 Madison! Oh, okay, sorry. He's not in there right now. Let's go. God, I have to press the buttons very hard. Okay, it's gonna drop some plans. Right, I need to figure out how I'm gonna slice some bitches. Okay. It's not quite like Ethan's plans when he's doing... Designing. He's a house designer. Interior designer. That's it. I was trying to think of the term. Hurry up, please. Get bored waiting for you. Whoa. Please, Sam. Just do as I say, darling. Okay. This is really sore on my thumb. Oh, wow. He's coming nowhere near me. That's awesome. Just send the police around to Leland White's house. I'm like, what time do you call this, bitches? I could have been dead by now. I am Captain Layden Perry. I'm going to serve this lady killer up on a silver platter. Stop fiddling with your box. Hurry up. Hurry up, police. My thumb is really getting numb, and that rhymes. Oh, it's I'm helping him get the sweat with nerves. Come on. I'm back, my darlings. I've been desperate to see you all again. Something like that here.
I'm back, my darlings.
Oh, he loves the word darling too. Darling. Oh, anxious to see you all again.
Morning, Mary. Oh, I know. I missed you too, Sarah.
It's not a good morning at all. It's a shit morning.
I love you just as much as all the others.
Fuck's sake. What kind of childhood did he have? How did he get to this point? Oh, God. Please hurry up, Sam. I swear, I'm killing my thumb by doing this. Yay! Fine. Oh, thank God. I think I just had a thumbgasm there, letting go of the controller. Woo! There we go. Finally got the end of the anguish. I was going to say trophy. No, we don't get a trophy for this. No trophy for this effort. But...
Police!
Woo! Police, open immediately. And I never died in the process. Woohoo! So we've got all endings now. Awesome. We should get a gold trophy for that alone.
Hands up, I said.
Hands up, I said, darling. Well, that's that then. And then Madison gets all depressed when she leaves. She's like, oh, how often am I going to have to face psycho sick as I get near misses with my death experiences? Just like with the doctor, which hasn't happened yet. Aw. She's depressed. Oh, that's, I know. She's empathizing with me. She's saying, I feel so bad that Steven's suffering from depression right now. I'm like, oh, thanks, darling. Right. Taxidermist. taxi service, yeah. That's one taxi service I'll not use. Okay, so thank you very much for watching my Let's Play of the Taxidermist DLC of Heavy Rain, guys. And that was about over half a year, actually, come think of it, since I played Heavy Rain. And I've finally done the DLC. How long has it been since I played Heavy Rain? It was June, April, May, June. Oh, God, 10 months ago? It doesn't feel that long since I introduced the game, but okay, hang on. The End of Anguish. End of Anguish? End of the Anguish? I don't know. Our journalist, Madison Page, risked her own life to investigate a dangerous serial killer who stuffed the hell out of his victims by killing them. After killing them. She was trapped in the killer's house as he returned home after she had broke in search of evidence. Fortunately for her, she alerted the police and owes her life for their timely intervention. She owes her life. They owed their life because I could have died in the process if he found me, so they can go fuck themselves. I am Bae, and I saved the day, so... Wow, that was actually very fun, apart from that last ending of her to get out, was really stressful, but it's probably just because I was dumb and messed a whole load of shit up on my first attempt there. But thank you very much for watching. I've been wanting to play it for ages, and such a short game it is, the DLC, and I am hoping to get back around to actually playing Heavy Rain again on the channel, among other stuff, of course. But... thank you very much for watching. Take care, guys, and a shout out to my Patreons, Mitchum Groovers, Kez Daddy, Samuel Fawcett, and Mika Morgan. Thank you very much for your pledges, and take care, guys. I'll see you later. There we are, all endings. Sacrificed in the name of the truth, in the middle of the horror, end of the anguish, where's Madison Page, and the end of the nightmare. It would have made more sense, like, the two on the right side of the page were sacrificed in the name of the truth, and where's Madison Page, that would be the two that she dies, and the three on the left are the ones that she lives. Just a small thing that I thought. And yeah, reload one of your save states, see how you can change your course of events. Yeah, I kept reloading Leland's back. I should have reloaded inside the house for the last one that I was trying to get. But seriously, thank you very much for watching, guys, and I hope to get more PS3 Let's Plays done soon, but this is one of the first things I actually wanted to play because I was kind of desperate to do this DLC when I got Heavy Rain for PS4, but I couldn't play it because it never came with the remaster. But thank you very much for watching. Take care. See you later. Oh, actually, one thing I might just say right now is when I was installing the game earlier, it actually showed you a tutorial on how to make that origami figure. It's on the screen. It's actually the Heavy Rain logo, but I forgot how to do it already. But I remember during it was installing, it showed you how to do it, but I forgot how to do it. And it is an actual origami thing you can do. So if any of you know how to do it, just comment down below if you know how to do that origami figure. I know someone who does, but thank you very much for watching, guys. I'll see you later. Yeah, I remember I spent pretty much, like, hours of my birthday trying to figure out why I couldn't sign into my PSN. I'm like, oh, such fun. But yeah, I've just managed to get signed into my CSN... CSN? Well, I'm like, I was trying to think CSI there, but I was like, because, oh yeah, because we're playing Evergreen. But pretty much... Oh, God, I'm saying but pretty much a lot today, but, so what happened was... Basically...